Yes. Good morning, guys. Good morning for the lecture 28. Good morning for the lecture 28 of Environmental Engineering subject. So, the last class of this week.
So, we have
two students to join. So, almost three students have joined. So, a good start. Yes. Welcome to the class. So in the last class, we have discussed about the topics called physical characteristics of wastewater, chemical characteristics of wastewater. And in this class, we have discussed about the biological characteristics of wastewater and also some of the problems, equations related to the biological oxygen demand, right? BOD, bio-oxygen demand. So in the last class, we have mentioned various categories of chemical characteristics, right? So what are the problems we are facing with chemical characteristics that is focused on the wastewater? Thereby, what are the effects we are facing? What are the effects we are facing with the chemically used wastewaters, right? So in this class, we'll see the biological examination, biological process, and also how to measure the BOD and COD, what are the BOD equations and problems. Okay. We need the, yeah. Yes. So this is your house, or it may be my house, or it may be anyone's house. The concept is same. Okay. Yes. So this is the same thing what I'm showing every day. ఇక్కడ ఈ యూనిట్ అయ్యేంతవరకు ఇది మైండ్ లో ఉండాలి. ఓకే, సీ ద ఫిగర్ వన్స్. సో యు ఆర్ హియర్, యు ఆర్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్, మై సెల్ఫ్, ఎవ్రీవన్ ఇన్ ద క్లాస్ రూమ్, యు ఆర్ హియర్. సో ద ఇండస్ట్రియల్ ఏరియాస్, దేస్ ఆర్ లొకేటెడ్ అట్ రూరల్ ఏరియాస్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ద ఇండస్ట్రియల్ ఏరియా అవుట్ సైడ్ ద సిటీ. దిస్ ఈస్ ద థింగ్ వేర్ యు ఆర్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సింగ్ నౌ. వర్షాకాలం పడుతుంది కాబట్టి ద స్టార్మ్ వాటర్ హౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫ్లోయింగ్ ఇన్ ద రివర్స్, పాండ్స్, కెనల్స్ యు ఆర్ సీయింగ్ అవుట్ సైడ్ ఆల్సో. ఓకే, రియల్ టైమ్ వేస్ట్ వాటర్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ నాట్ ఇన్ ఇండియా, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ అబ్రాడ్. బై దిస్ ఫిగర్స్, బై దిస్ ట్రీస్ యూ కెన్ సే ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎంటైర్లీ, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎంటైర్లీ ఇన్ ద అదర్ కంట్రీ. సో మన కంట్రీలో ఐ థింక్ ఐ విల్ నాట్ సీ దిస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ హైజీన్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ వేస్ట్ వాటర్ మేనేజ్మెంట్, రైట్? Yes. So we have completed the chemical characteristics. Now we are seeing the biological characteristics. Now see here the impact of biological oxygen demand, the impact of biological oxygen demand on dissolved oxygen. So dissolved oxygen gurinchi manam last class lo cheptunnamu. Whenever the oxygen is dissolved in the river, so what happens to the aquatic life? What happens to the aquatic life? See, the water direction of flow is in this direction generally. Okay. So you are having phases here, the phases of the river in the BOD. A clean zone, trout, perch, bass. So these are some technical scientific names where the materials are present inside the water. Next, decomposition zone, trash fish, leeches. Septic zone, fish absent, sludge forms, midge and mosquito larva. Recovery zone, trash fish, leeches, isopods. Clean zone, again trout, perch, bass, mayfly, stonefly, calyptus. So what this one is saying means, what the stages are saying means, so whenever initially the water is in this stage, clean zone lo unnappudu, these are the things what they are surviving. So whenever it is changing to decomposition stage, so what happens? Trash fish, leeches are going. Whenever it is converting into septic zone, so what happens? Fish is not present. Student, see here. So these are the things stage by stage happening. So at this stage, so slowly the level is increasing because decomposition zone start out in gravity. It is increasing to the level and decomposition is taking place. Oxygen cycle, loss of oxygen, right? Whenever the loss of oxygen is there, ee stage kuch sir ke injury kind. Ee stage low. We don't have any fish. We don't have any other categories. We don't have any reptiles. Thereby, what happens? The growth of this bacteria, the growth of mosquitoes, the growth of mosquito larvae are getting produced. Next, malli whenever it is going to the recovery stage, what happens? Slowly the transvestites are coming into the existence, coming into the existence. Whenever again is going to the clean zone, so mundu manam edaithe dissolved oxygen with the biochemical demand lo undo malli adhe manaki stage ostundi. So what the scientific researchers are saying means, so whenever you are throwing the wastewater, through pipes or canals into the ocean, what's happening inside the ocean? So general people or many environmentalists or other NGO people say samudramulo unna jeevulaki it becomes a problem, but they are saying it is a cyclic process. So damage untundi, for example in a rainy season manaku varsha kalamlo manholes open aitadi. Recently 3 days or 2 days back in the news also in Hyderabad narrowband you have seen one 8 years girl cycle dokuntu manhole lo padi one day tarvata పోలీస్ కంప్లైంట్ ఇచ్చిన తర్వాత చెక్ చేసిన తర్వాత సిసి ఫుటేజెస్ తర్వాత షీ ఫెల్డ్ ఇన్ ఎ మ్యాన్ హోల్ అండ్ లాస్ట్ హిస్ లైఫ్ లాస్ట్ హర్ లైఫ్ సో ఇందాక మనం ముందు క్లాసెస్ లో మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ గురించి చెప్పుకున్నాం వాట్ ఇస్ ద మెయిన్ పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ అపరెంటెన్సెస్ అండ్ మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ బట్ టుడే ద మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ ఆర్ ద డెడ్ జోన్స్ ఫర్ ద హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్ రైట్ సో ఎవ్రీ వర్షాకాలంలో ఎవ్రీ సీజన్స్ లో ఎవ్రీ రైనీ సీజన్స్ లో పాండమిక్ లో మనుషులు ఎలా చనిపోతున్నారో మళ్ళీ ఎలా పుడుతున్నారో ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే ఫర్ దిస్ ఓషన్ ఆల్సో ఓషన్ లో ఉన్న జీవులకు ప్రాణులకు వెన్ఎవర్ ద వాటర్ ఈస్ వేస్ట్ వాటర్ ఇస్ డంపింగ్ ఇన్ టు ద సీ వాటర్ ఆర్ ఓషన్ వాటర్ ఓషన్ సో ఇక్కడ కూడా ద సేమ్ ప్రాసెస్ హ్యాపెన్స్ అగైన్ ద సైక్లిక్ ప్రాసెస్ గోస్ ఆన్ సో దిస్ షోస్ ఇప్పుడు దీన్ని ఈ పేపర్ ఈ ఫోటోని మీరు సిలిండర్ లాగా చుట్టారనుకోండి ఏం జరుగుతుంది మళ్ళీ సైక్లిక్ ప్రాసెస్ స్టార్ట్ అవుతుంది రైట్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ టు హియర్ రైట్ నెక్స్ట్ టాపిక్ ఇస్ బయోలాజికల్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ ఆఫ్ వేస్ట్ వాటర్ సో వాట్ ఆర్ ద థింగ్స్ యూఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ హియర్ టు డిస్కస్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ద ఆక్వాటిక్ ప్లాంట్స్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ద ఆక్వాటిక్ అనిమల్స్ ఆక్వాటిక్ మోల్డ్స్ బ్యాక్టీరియా అండ్ వైరస్ So, the plants, you know the plants. So, what are the plants where they are growing enormously in the seawater? Not only in the seawater, river water, pond water. So, what are the plants? Here you can see algae. You can see some sort of bushy plants. You can see some sort of dry plants without having any living creature in there, without having any living thing in there. So the aquatic plants, the marine plants, the aquatic animals, the aquatic molds, bacteria and virus. So most of the organisms are in a diverse group of bacteria, algae, fungus, virus and protozoa. So when coming to the aquatic molds such as bacteria, we are having a number of microorganisms present inside the water. If you see the figure, you can see this one. See, this is one type of bacteria, this is one type of bacteria, one type of bacteria, one type of virus, one type of algae, one type of small larva. So like this you are having. So if you see the aquatic plants, so recently in the river ponds you can see number of aquatic plants are growing. So konni manam em cheptamo mada chettlu, mada aakulu. So other things we can say gurrapu dekkalu. Other things we can say gurrapu tekkalu, right? Meer peru vine untaru horseshoe type of leaves that are also the plants which are growing in the rivers and ponds which makes obstructions to the flow of the water, right? Next, other bacteria, other microorganisms like protozoa, fungi, protifers, worms, round forms, etc. So these are all the things where they are present inside the water and disturbing the water function along with the aquatic plants and the aquatic animals. Now, so what are the biological constituents means animals, open water resources and treatment. So the plants, open water resources and treatment. So what is the remedy for plants? So the water should be open water courses and treatment plants. So the other type of bacteria, domestic waste, surface water infiltration, treatment plants. Other type of arc bacteria, domestic waste, surface water infiltration and treatment plants. viruses coming from the domestic waste. So manaki coronavirus anedi ippudu manam chustunnam, but if you see the family of coronavirus already exist in a 3-4-5 years back in other countries, and also if you see the roadside your canals murugundallo kuda you can see the virus, but which are not that much harmful to the human being when compared to the coronavirus. But in the initial classes also I have said, so regarding to our hygiene, regarding the hygiene, so if those who are eating near roadside food, near where the people, where the vendor is keeping, nearby the canals, nearby any dusty area, nearby any unhygiene area, so it is very very unsafe to have a food in such type of places. So pani puri bandi, your fried rice, so I think majority of pani puri people are placing their vehicle, placing their cart, vala bandlu ekkada pettunaru, so generally they are keeping at the junction of any canals, kalaval daggara, junction kalaval daggara, enna manchi kalava unna chota lonely areas ekkada pettunaru. Why? To dispose the material, once tinna tarvata material dispose cheyali kabatti easy ga undadaniki he is keeping near the junction point of any canal. But the person who knows about the hygienity, he will escape from that type of process. So only baita kanabade coloring, baita kanabade cart chusi majority of people are coming and having some food. So whenever this type of things, because now the rainy season is coming, so automatically you are getting different sort of problems, health problems apart from corona. So in order to avoid that, what are the things you have to do? You have to maintain home food, you have to prepare home food, you have to eat it, you have to drink a lot of water, but the water should be not contaminated. Ekkada padthe akkada water tagadandi. Whenever you are going outside, take a bottle, take a 1 liter bottle or 2 liter bottle or 2 half liter bottles, keep in your bag and travel anywhere where you want to go outside for 1 hour work also, right? Like this. What are the biological characteristics? The environment engineer should keep in mind the knowledge of biological of wastewater, because it is very important characteristics factor in wastewater treatment. The engineer should know what the engineer, the environment engineer should know means the principal groups. First, he has to know how to divide the microorganisms, right? So whenever the environment engineer has to study about the biological characteristics of the wastewater, initially he has to see the classification of microorganisms under the classification, subclass classification under the examples. The first principal groups of microorganisms found in the wastewater, he has to see the groups in the groups of microorganisms. Next, the second one is what are the pathogenic organisms, right? Next one is the indicator organisms, indicate the presence of pathogens. Pathogens undadaniki karanamaina organisms kuda we have to identify. Fourth one, the methods used to amount the count or amount the microorganisms. What are the methods? What are the methods usually available for counting or for measuring the microorganisms? Fifth one, the methods to evaluate the toxicity of treated wastewater. So what are the available methods to evaluate toxicity of treated water? So once the water is treated, what are the methods to found? What are the methods to find the nature of the water? That is by using what is the percentage of toxicity? And the percentage of toxins are available in the wastewater we have to check. The main groups of microorganisms. So what are the main groups that an environmental engineer should know about the microorganisms? The main microorganisms of concern in wastewater treatment are the bacteria, fungi, algae, and protozoa, virus, and pathogens microorganism groups, right? So ee words already meeru school days classes lo biology subject lo meeru vine untaru. Now the bacteria. In that bacteria, what are the types of bacteria? You are having spheroid type, rod carbonate type, spiral type, filamentous type, some important bacteria. So bacteria, we are not dealing in depth. Pipe enemy, just we are seeing only the types. సో స్పెరాయిడ్స్ అంటే ఏంటి రౌండ్ గా ఉంటుంది సో రౌండ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ బ్యాక్టీరియాస్ ఉంటాయి రాడ్ కర్వ్డ్ రాడ్ అంటే రాడ్ కర్వ్ టైప్ అంటే సో రాడ్స్ లాగా ఉంటుంది మీరు తింటారు కదా ఫ్రైమ్స్ చిప్స్ లాగా సో రాడ్స్ లాగా కర్వ్డ్ షేప్ అయి ఉంటుంది నెక్స్ట్ స్పైరల్ షేప్ స్పైరల్ షేప్స్ మీన్స్ కాయిల్స్ లాగా చుట్టలు చుట్టలు చుట్టుకొని ఉంటుంది ఫిలమెంటస్ టైప్స్ మీన్స్ చిన్న చిన్న బార్ కార్పస్ లాగా యూఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ దట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ బ్యాక్టీరియా నెక్స్ట్ సుడోమోనాస్ ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ అ సుడోమోనాస్ సో వాట్ ఇస్ ద థింగ్ టు రిడ్యూస్ ఇట్ వి రిక్వైర్ అండ్ O3 to N2 nitrogen. So it is very important in biological nitrate removal in treatment works. So E methods used to see we can remove the bacteria count or bacteria family in the washed water. Next. Geolia helps through its slime production in the formation of flocks in the aeration tanks. This is also other method where the slime is produced in the formation of flocks in the aerated tank where the oxygen is present in the tanks we are having these types of technology. Next. Spheriotulous natrons. These are all the scientific technical terms used in biology, right? These are causes sludge bulking in the aeration tanks. So this type of method makes the sludge and then next last unit lo undachu sludge processing ante entani. The sludge is a physical component, physical waste, where it is counting, where it is volumetrically increasing in the aerated tank. Next, Delovibrio, which destroys the pathogens in biological treatment. These are the methods where you are destroying or killing or reducing the growth of biologically microorganisms present in the wastewater. So what this Delovibrio is doing, it is destroying the pathogens. అంటే ఏదైతే బ్యాక్టీరియా పుట్టడానికి కారణమవుతున్న ఫ్యాక్టర్స్ ద ప్యాథోజెన్స్ ని ఇట్ విల్ డెస్ట్రాయ్ ఇన్ ద బయోలాజికల్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ మెథడ్ నెక్స్ట్ అసిటినోబ్యాక్టర్ సో స్టోర్స్ లార్జ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఫాస్ఫేట్ సో ఇవి ఎగ్జామ్స్ ఏం రావు బస్ దే విల్ ఆస్క్ ద వాట్ ఆర్ ద బయోలాజికల్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ జస్ట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు మెన్షన్ బెస్ట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రైట్ దిస్ బయోలాజికల్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ రైట్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద బయోలాజికల్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ హౌ దే ఆర్ affecting the wastewater annapudu you have to write by taking these terms into consideration you have to write on your own yes stores large amount of phosphate under aerobic conditions and release it under an anaerobic condition so they are useful in phosphate removal next nitrosomans transform NH4 into nitrogen oxide next nitrobacter transforms NO2 to NO3 next coliform bacteria the common type the most common type of E. coli or Escherichia coli indicated the presence of pathogens it is showing how much amount of pathogens are located next E. coli is measured in 100 ml nitrogen per 100 ml number of countable bacteria by in 100 ml of water how much amount of bacteria is present it is done by E. coli measurement So if you see the real microorganisms, the bacteria So if you see the bacteria in the wastewater through microscope, so you can see this type of bacteria present in the wastewater. See how it is. So recently 1 week back, I think so. Some of the laboratories in other countries have released the picture how the coronavirus is elasta already coronavirus microscopic structure meer chuse untaru right but whenever the treatment started whenever the vaccine anedi ఎప్పుడైతే ఒక మనిషికి ఇంజెక్షన్ చేసిన తర్వాత ఫేజెస్ ఉంటాయి కదా డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ ద డేస్ సో ఆ టైంలో దే హ్యావ్ క్యాప్చర్డ్ ద వీడియో కెమెరా దే హ్యావ్ క్యాప్చర్డ్ ద పిక్స్ దే హ్యావ్ క్యాప్చర్డ్ ద ఇమేజెస్ ఆఫ్ హౌ ద కరోనా ఈస్ జస్ట్ హౌ ద వ్యాక్సిన్ ఈస్ జస్ట్ ఫర్ ద కరోనా స్టేజ్ బై స్టేజ్ సో దాన్ని వీడియో రీసెంట్గా రిలీజ్ చేశారు సో ద హౌ ద కరోనా ఈస్ డిస్ట్రాయింగ్ ద హౌ ద వ్యాక్సిన్ ఈస్ డిస్ట్రాయింగ్ ద కరోనా ఇన్ ద లంగ్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్ అదర్ ట్రాకియా ఆర్ ఇన్ ఓసోఫేగస్ బాడీలో ఉన్న పార్ట్స్ how it is destroying anedi oka video release chesaru. So you can see how naturally, how realistically it is destroying the corona cells, right? So idi kuda meeru if you see through microscope the different forms of bacteria you can observe, right? See here, it is in the form of rod shape, curved shape. It is a form of spheroid shape, form of worm shape. See, it is the form of different kidney bean shape. So it is in a different shapes, right? How it is forming. Next, fungus. Fungus is also important in decomposing organic matter to the simple forms, right? Algae causes eutrophication phenomena, negative effect. Algae is forming the negative effect to the water process. Useful in oxidation ponds, positive effect. So positive effect ekta useful in oxidation ponds. Algae ekku unna kodde em jarugutundi, chepala santati anedi perugutundi, right? Next, causes taste and problems when decayed. When it is decayed, it is causing some problems, which is a negative effect. Protozoa feed on bacteria, so they help in the purification of treated wastewater. So what happens to the, what is the protozoa is saying? Is a feed on bacteria. Protozoa feeds on bacteria, so that help in purification of treated wastewater. So if protozoa anedi, it is feeds on bacteria and help the purification. It also, the protozoa helps in purification of the wastewater. Next, some of them are pathogenic. These are the scientific names, biological scientific names, what we are discussing. Now see the figure of this various fungus algae, right? So some are in the water, some are in the hand, some are in the trees. See the hand, see the person's hand, see the chettu kommalu, chettu moddu, chettu bark, majjalo perige other some forms of material. So if you see some persons, those who are continuously working in forest, so adullone batikestaru. So for that people, so recently some video has been seen. So the person, automatically the person kaalu chetulu same whatever the algae, whatever the fungus, so everything is spreaded. His hands, legs, borlu kuda ela perigayi ante oka chettu kommalu, chettu berad laga velalo nunchi your fungus. For example, if you see in any buildings gaani, mee itikala daggara itika goda pakkana gaani, automatically konni chinna chinna mokkalu perugutu untayi. ఎవరు అక్కడ నువ్వు ఎవరు విత్తనం వేసారు ఇడు ఉన్నావు, బట్ ఇన్ సమ్ ప్లేసెస్ ఇన్ వాల్స్ మధ్యలో క్రాక్స్ లోపల, ఇంటి గోడ పైన, లేదంటే ఏదో ఒక ప్లేసెస్ లో, ఒక కార్నర్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ రూమ్స్, మెల్లిగా చిన్న చిన్న ప్లాంట్స్ పెరుగుతుంటాయి. ఎలా పెరుగుతుందో ఇడు ఉన్నావు. ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే సమ్ పీపుల్, దోస్ ఆర్ కంటిన్యూస్లీ లివింగ్ ఇన్ ద ఫారెస్ట్, కంటిన్యూస్లీ లివింగ్ అరౌండ్ ద బ్యాంక్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎ రివర్, నది ఒడ్డున ఉన్న వాళ్ళకి, so this type of skin already exist for that people. So vala chetulu lopal nunchi rendu vela madhyalo chinna chinna plants mulavadamo, akada algae fungus form avadamo, oka chettu laga vala chetulu maaripodamo kaallu. So you can see in some other documentaries available in NGC also, National Geographic Channel, right? Next one is a virus. See the virus structure. So this is one virus structure. Coronavirus manaki already telusu round ga untundi, dan paina different needles laga untundi. So this is also one shape of virus where it is present in the water. The viruses are the major hazard to public health. Ante kada, some virus can live as long as 41 days in water and wastewater at 20 degrees centigrade. They cause lot of dangerous diseases. So see the days, how many days. So 41 days ane by 41 days kuda jeevinche virus lo kuda unnai water lo at 20 degrees centigrade. That's why in this rainy season and winter season, majority household people, whenever you want to drink water, boil the water to some high temperature degrees and cool the water, tarvata meeru consume cheyandi up to February, right? So that's why many people, many doctors, many scientific people are saying that drink water regularly, maximum take water instead of solids. Ippudunna corona time lo recent research enti, drink lots of water so that you can avoid corona. Not avoid corona, you can prevent it entering into your body. Drink lots of water, Why? Because whenever you're drinking lots of water, whatever the toxins, whatever the other things in the body, the gap, మీ ఓసోపేగస్ ఓసోపేగస్ అంటే గొంతులో ఉండే ఒక అన్నవాహిక ఓసోపేగస్ ట్రాకియా ఆ పార్ట్ అంతా క్లీన్ అవుతుంది ఎవ్రీ టైం వాష్ చేస్తున్న కొద్ది ఏమి జరుగుతుంది లోపల క్లీన్ గా ఉంటుంది రైట్ సో దట్స్ వై ఇన్ దిస్ రైనీ సీజన్ అండ్ వింటర్ సీజన్ టిల్ ఫిబ్రవరి ఫ్రమ్ టుడే ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ సెప్టెంబర్ అక్టోబర్ నవంబర్ డిసెంబర్ సో మ్యాక్సిమం ట్రై టు డ్రింక్ వాటర్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఇన్ వార్మ్ కండిషన్ అవాయిడ్ డ్రింకింగ్ కోల్డ్ వాటర్ వై బికాస్ సీ హియర్ సింపుల్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఒక వైరస్ అనేది మినిమం 41 డేస్ బతికే ఛాన్సెస్ ఉంది ఎక్కడ 20 డిగ్రీ సెంటిగ్రేడ్ లో కూడా ఉండే ఛాన్సెస్ ఉంది సో దేర్ బై జస్ట్ సీ హౌ డేంజరస్ ఫర్ ద హ్యూమన్ బాడీ సో ఈ విధంగా చూసుకుంటే మెజారిటీ ఆఫ్ అవర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద హ్యూమన్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద డిసీజెస్ యు ఆర్ గెటింగ్ సో బేస్డ్ అపాన్ ద వాటర్ ఓన్లీ అండ్ ఆల్సో అదర్ ఫుడ్ లైక్ జంక్ ఫుడ్ pathogenic organisms the main categories of pathogens are bacteria virus protozoa and helminths see the shape of the virus so it is a tail portion so there is a sheath is a rod is a nucleic acid is a capsid so we don't know generally technical terms so just is the shape of a virus which is present inside the water now see what are the anaerobic processes and aerobic processes takes place in the biological process then what is the meaning of anaerobic process anaerobic process means the decomposition of organic matter so organic matter decomposition aithe it is nothing but the putrefaction is nothing but putrefaction and the result is called liquefaction as the solid organic matter dissolved by the enzymes right the decomposition of organic matter is called putrefaction and the result is called liquefaction as a solid organic matter dissolved by the enzymes so deentlo solid matter anedi solid organic matter is dissolved in the water and converting into putrefaction by decomposition of organic matter next anaerobic bacteria oxidize organic matter utilizing the electronic acceptors other than oxygen in carrying out their metabolic processes they produce carbon dioxide they are getting hydrogen oxide hydrogen sulfide methane NH3 N2 reduced organics and more bacteria treatment units which work on the putrefaction along are septic tanks Wim Hof tanks and sludge digestion tanks so putrefaction decomposition of organic matter jaragalante for water so which is a best place for this decomposition with that is the septic tanks Wim Hof tanks and sludge digestion tanks for the anaerobic process next what is the aerobic process the aerobic process means the work of aerobic bacteria that is a combination with oxygen is called oxidation so whenever the process is going on without oxygen we are calling them as a anaerobic process whenever the process is going on with oxygen in the presence of oxygen you are calling them as a aerobic process right next aerobic bacteria utilize free oxygen as a electron acceptor the end products of the aerobic activity are CO2 H2O SO2 NO3 NH3 and more bacteria right so the aerobic bacteria em jarugutundi utilizes free oxygen as a electron acceptor adhe mundu case lo anaerobic bacteria oxidizes organic matter utilizing the electron acceptors other than oxygen oxygen kaakunda vere gases ni teesukoni danni reaction jarugutunna danni we are calling them as anaerobic bacteria so oxidizer ni teesukoni oxidizer ni utilize chesukoni as a electron acceptor ga danni manamu reaction jarugutunte we are calling them as anaerobic bacteria right though each of the above two processes work in opposite direction the former by splitting up and the latter by building up so former em jarigindi edi anaerobic bacteria splitting jarigindi aerobic bacteria lo building up jarigindi there is a coordination between the two in the first stage the anaerobic bacteria decompose complex organic matter into simple organic compounds so anaerobic bacteria lo what happens the microorganisms decompose కాంప్లెక్స్ ఆర్గానిక్ మ్యాటర్ నుంచి సింపుల్ ఆర్గానిక్ మ్యాటర్గా డీకంపోజ్ అయ్యింది. వైల్ ద సెకండ్ స్టేజ్ ద అరబిక్ బ్యాక్టీరియా ఆక్సిడైజ్ దెమ్ ఇన్ టు స్టేబుల్ కాంపౌండ్స్. సో అనరబిక్ బ్యాక్టీరియా ప్రాసెస్లో ఏం జరిగింది, ఇట్ ఈస్ మేకింగ్ ద బ్యాక్టీరియా ఆక్సిడైజ్ దెమ్ ఇన్ టు స్టేబుల్ కాంపౌండ్స్ ద్వారా దిస్ కన్వర్టింగ్. సో దట్ ఈస్ అ ప్రాసెస్ గోయింగ్ ఆన్ ఇన్ ద అనరబిక్ బ్యాక్టీరియా అండ్ అరబిక్ ప్రాసెసెస్. So in this also, in this biological, in the biochemical characteristics also, we are having the BOD and COD analysis. So in the chemical process, here also we are having the BOD and COD analysis with respect to biological characteristics. I will just say chemical characteristics, you will just say biological characteristics. Now see, the BOD is defined as oxygen required for the microorganisms to carry out biological decomposition of dissolved solids in the wastewater under aerobic condition or at standard temperature. So standard temperature low under aerobic condition, under aerobic condition at standard temperature, the wastewater is used where the oxygen required for the microorganism to carry out biological decomposition. Okay, standard temperature low under presence of oxygen low, right? How to carry the biological decomposition of dissolved solids and then manam em antam biochemical oxygen demand. Then what is chemical oxygen demand? COD is determined only in 3 hours in contrast to 5 hours. So COD lo em jarugutundi chemically oxygen is dissolving in the water at standard temperature. So this COD analysis is determined 3 hours per we can detect the experiment. Whereas in the BOD, it takes around 5 days to go for the BOD test. In COD test, a strong chemical oxidizing agent is used in acidic medium to measure the oxygen equivalent of organic matter that can be oxidized. So COD analysis, so we are using a strong chemical agent for testing of the oxygen levels in the water. How the BOD test results are used in the following purpose. So when compared to manamu mundu cheptunna chemical characteristics lo COD analysis you are getting the solution in 3 hours, whereas in the BOD analysis you are getting the solution 5 days. So when comparing these two, the BOD tests are giving the long lasting results when compared to the COD analysis. Then what are the results obtained from the BOD test, means purpose, what are the main purpose of doing the BOD test? Determination of approximate quantity of oxygen. Determination of approximate quantity of oxygen required for biological stabilization. Biological stable avadaniki approximate quantity of oxygen we are using for determination. Second one, determination of size of wastewater treatment facilities. So BOD test conduct cheyalante the first thing is to check the size of the wastewater facility. So we have to see how much volume of wastewater is present, what is the area of wastewater in the locality. Third one, measure the efficiency of some treatment processes. So we have to measure the efficiencies of the other treatment processes which are carrying along with the BOD test. Fourth one, determination of strength of sewage. So we have to see the concentration, we have to see the other facilities of the sewage. This is the strength. So it is a weak or it is a normal or it is a good strength, like this. Strength means the process, strength means the way going for the test. Ante test cheyadaniki daniki sufficient energy, so ante a water ki sufficient cat sufficient requirements features unnaya leda, that is the meaning of strength of sewage. Fifth one, determination of amount of clear water required for the efficient disposal of wastewater by dilution. So you have to determine the amount of clear water required for the efficient disposal of wastewater by dilution method. Next, relative stability. It is the ratio of available oxygen to the required oxygen satisfying the first stage of BOD. Relative stability. Ratio of oxygen availability to the oxygen satisfying first stage. Population equivalent. Population equivalent PE is equals to total BOD 5. And 5 days, BOD 5. Of industrial wastewater divided by BOD5 value per capita per day. So that is a ratio of population equivalent. P is equals to total BOD fine divided by BOD per capita per day. Next, BOD is the most important parameter in water pollution control. So water pollution control board, law, if you go and visit any water pollution control office, BOD plays a very vital role for their processes. It is used as a measure of organic pollution as a basis of estimating the organic needed for biological processes and as an indicator of process performance. So what it's saying, it is also used to measure the organic pollution on the basis of the needs of biological processes. Next. If you see the reaction here, if you see the equation, the organic matter cells plus oxygen is give rise to carbon dioxide plus H2O plus new cells, right? Organic, what is it? The organic matter present in the water plus oxygen what you are sending. So the reaction takes place in the presence of microorganism. We are getting carbon dioxide, we are getting H2O water plus new cells formation. See the BOD bottle. So meer labs lo chuste BOD bottle ila untundi, deen lopala manamu water dillo insert the water manamu set chesi we are adding something for a test of the biological test. So the biological test takes place 5 days at 20 degrees centigrade. So other thing is 3 days at 30 degrees centigrade, right? Next. So this is a physical structure of a bottle, glass bottle, where you are conducting BOD test. Next one is calculation of BOD. Calculation of BOD. BOD is equals to DO minus DO, DOI minus DOT by P. Then what is BODT? Biological, biochemical oxygen demand, mg per liter, right? Mg per liter. Then what is DOI? Initial dissolved oxygen, initial dissolved oxygen of a diluted wastewater, initial DO of a diluted wastewater sample about 15 minutes after preparation. After preparation, 15 minutes after preparation, how the diluted water is used for the sample. That is also measured in mg per liter. Next, DOT, final DO of diluted wastewater sample after incubation for 5 days. So manam 5 days test chestunnam kabatti after incubation of 5 days. Next, P is a digestion factor. So how to find the BOD means the ratio of DOI minus DOT, initial testing, initial dissolved oxygen minus final dissolved oxygen, divided by dilution factor, where P is a dilution factor. Okay, so that implies volume of sample divided by volume of sample plus volume of distilled water. So that implies the dilution. What is the meaning of dilution factor here? While dilution factor P is equals to volume of sample divided by volume of sample plus volume of dissolved water. Next, the ultimate BOD. Ultimate BOD short form is LO. The ultimate BOD is defined as the maximum BOD exerted by the waste. Maximum BOD exerted by the waste. So we'll stop the class here. I think the time is very less than 1 minute. So we'll continue the class. So generally these things will not get in exam, but problems vachinappudu, we are having one or two problems. See, problems kosam we have to just understand the concept of BOD equations, right? So we'll stop the class here. So I will upload this video in the group. Later the link is forwarded to your WhatsApp. Just open the video after 10 minutes or 15 minutes. Just view it. Evaraithe class lo lero, personally ga meeku friends evaraithe unnaro, just forward those link to those person through WhatsApp. Thanks for listening to the class. Hope you enjoyed the class. So tomorrow is a Sunday. Have a nice day. So we'll meet on a Monday's class. Thank you. Thanks for listening.